Good morning, Horror Construction. Okay, guys, today we're going to go over how to get started with our basic foundations. With our template open, we're going to go to level one, and the first thing we're going to do is insert our CAD file S201 and position it about the origin to origin and hit open. Now I'll right click and say zoom to fit, and with this CAD file now inserted, I'll select it, and you'll notice that I need to unpin it before I move the CAD file. And I want to place our origins over column line A1, A and 1, and I'll do that by selecting the CAD file and click the move command and place it over our intersection in our template. Now I will repin it so that I don't accidentally move our CAD file later on. The next step is we want to get started by placing our grid lines over the CAD file. And there are two ways to do this. The first way is to select our existing grid lines, and we want to make one minor change first and go to edit type and make sure that the plan view symbols are checked at both ends. And now we'll select our grid file. With our grid file selected, grid line selected, we'll simply use the copy command to place our grids. You'll notice that I'll need to override the grid names, and this can be done as you go along by placing the grids, or come back later at a later time and make that change. Another thing you'll notice when copying is that I want to make sure that my dimensions in my CAD file match the dimensions in Revit. So as I go along, I'll place several of these, and at this point you'll notice that I'll need to either select the CAD files, and they're all locked to each other. I can grab this little circle here to move those, or I can simply right click and say select all instances, and right click again and say maximize 3D extents. This will take all of the grid lines and pull them out to the extents of the drawings. The other way to place our grid lines is go to our home command, grid, and use the pick lines tool to place a grid file, a grid line over on top of the CAD file. Here, again, I'll need to modify the grid name as we go along. But all the while, I want to make sure that I check my dimensions and check my grid names so that they match. At this point, we're ready to start placing our foundations. So we're going to go to the Home tab, Foundation, and use our Properties tab to place our isolated foundations. You'll notice that with these grid lines in place, it's much easier to snap to the intersection of the column lines. And I'm just going to go through and place several of these as here I've not placed one, so it's having a trouble snapping to the intersection unless I zoom in. So now I will want to, there's a couple ways to do this as well. As I'll place several of these foundations, and then I can just use my control command and select several grid lines and use my properties tab to modify those as needed. The next thing we'll do is place our continuous footings. The way we do that is by using a beam command, and we have a grade beam that we will, a grade beam family that we're using for our continuous footings. To do that, I want to get as close as possible to the edge of my foundation. Oops. And we'll need to make sure and check, depending on which way we're placing this this foundation, change it from the center justification to the side. And let's try that again. I'll place it. And now we're aligned there. I'll go to my next one. And you'll notice that as long as I get close, these grade beams will automatically connect with my foundation. Here we have a footing step. What we'll do here is we'll need to first place the first footing step at the edge. We'll come back with this is a 1 foot footing step, so we'll place our second footing step below that, and we'll need to try that again. And we'll come back and align these in just a second, but finally I'll place my remaining footing step on top of the other footing step. Now the next step that we need to do is go to our 3D view, and here we can go to our view command and tile the views. Try tile, and we can zoom in on where these are in our model. Now, one thing that we need to do is to select our foundations, and this particular foundation will be offset 3'4" from our finished floor. This foundation here will also be offset 3'4", along with, and we'll need to set the offsets for both the start and the end offset. Since this is a 1 foot footing step, the next little piece is going to be offset 2'4", and the next offset will be, end offset will be 2'4" as well. And finally, this footing step will be offset and 1'4". Now the last thing that we need to do is we will use the align command to align our footing step by clicking on the one we want to align to first, and then click the edge of our of the footing step, and you'll notice that these footing steps will all be aligned to each other. So that concludes this segment of our horror training.